the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with
this Trinity weekend, brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, prepare to celebrate worthily the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you are mighty God and Prince of Peace. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Son of God and the Son of Mary. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord Jesus, you are the Word made flesh and splendor of the Father. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Mighty God, have mercy on us, forgive us all our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Reading from the book of Exodus. Early in the morning, Moses went up to Mount Sinai, as the Lord had commanded him, taking along the two stone tablets. Having come down in a cloud, the Lord stood with Moses there and proclaimed his name, Lord. Thus the Lord passed before him and cried out, "The Lord! The Lord, a merciful and gracious God, slow to anger and rich in kindness and fidelity." Moses at once bowed down to the ground in worship. Then he said, "If I find favor with you, O Lord, do come along in our company. This is indeed a stiff-necked people. Yet pardon our wickedness and sins, and receive us as your own." The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Thank you.
Reading from the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians. Brothers and sisters, rejoice, mend your ways, encourage one another, agree with one another, live in peace. And the God of love and peace will be with you. Greet one another with a holy kiss. All the holy ones greet you. The grace of the Lord Jesus Christ and the love of God and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit will be with all of you. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
He writes in Latin, si comprehendis non est Deus, If you have understood, then what you have understood is not God. If you have understood, then what you have understood is not God. So if we think we've understood what God is all about, whatever it is we think we've understood, certainly is a God. Whenever we try to think of God, to imagine what God is like, we experience a tug of war. On the one hand, yes, God is transcendent. But on the other hand, God is immanent, meaning he is also near to us. When applied to God, the word immanent means that God pervades and sustains all things. He is omnipresent, he is all around. Transcendence is a way of describing the total and utter otherness of God. No human words, no concepts, no images or ideas can ever make a beginning in our quest to know what God is like. But, as Christians, we believe that God has chosen to reveal himself through the intimate and personal presence of Jesus Christ. So God is both hidden and revealed. The first reading today from the book of Exodus and the Gospel are both about the imminence or the nearness of God. While on Mount Sinai, Moses appeals to God, "Lord, let my Lord come with us, I beg." And God does remain with his people, present to them in the tent of meeting. And in the beginning of John's Gospel, it says that the Word became flesh and pitched his tent among us, meaning Jesus is the very presence of God with us. In today's Gospel, it says that God so loved the world that he sent his only Son. Again, all this tells us is that God is not satisfied by remaining remote from us. God wishes to be near us. And last week, we celebrated the coming of the Holy Spirit at Pentecost, the culmination of the revelation of God as Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. So brothers and sisters, God is love, as St. John the Apostle wrote in his letter. He is a loving relationship between three persons, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Although we'll never completely understand God, we can, as St. John tells us, live in love and therefore live in God. So let us love one another, for to love another person is to see the face of God. Stand now and proudly profess our faith. I believe in one God, the Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth, of all things visible and invisible. I believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, born of the Father before all ages, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, consubstantial with the Father, through whom all things were made. For us men, for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and by the Holy Spirit was born of the Virgin Mary, and became man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried, and rose again on the third day, in accordance with the Scriptures. He ascended into heaven, and is seated at the right hand of the Father. He will come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end.
Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For this world, that it may be saved through the Son sent by the Father. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who do not accept the true God, that they may come to the peace and love of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For ourselves, celebrating this Eucharist, that we may help one another with the love which reflects the Trinity, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our dead, that they may rejoice forever in the glorious life of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Especially pray this Mass. This is offered for the eternal and happy repose of the souls of David and Greg Flory. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
Eternal Father, receive the prayers of his people filled with the Holy Spirit and offered in Christ, your only Son, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. My sacrifice and yours may be something to God and Almighty Father. Sanctified by the invocation of your name, we pray, O Lord our God, this oblation of our service, and by it make of us an eternal offering to you through Christ our Lord. Amen. The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere, to give you thanks, Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, who with your only begotten Son and the Holy Spirit, you are one God, one Lord, not in the unity of a single person, but in the Trinity of one substance. For what you have revealed to us of your glory, we believe equally of your Son and of the Holy Spirit, so that in confessing of the true and eternal Godhead, you might be adored in what is proper to each person, their unity in substance and their equality in majesty. For this is praised by angels and archangels, cherubim too, and seraphim, who never cease to cry out each day as with one voice they acclaim. In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. This is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will pour out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and William, our Bishop, and all the clergy, religious, and your entire people. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your faith. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, and we merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever. Graciously grant her peace and duty in accordance with your will to live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always. Let's offer each other the sign of peace. Let us pray. May receiving the sacrament, O Lord our God, bring us health of body and soul as we confess your eternal Holy Trinity and undivided unity through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Please be seated for a special Mass. Thank you.
Children kindergarten to fifth grade, sixth grade and up, can volunteer. And we also, thanks to a generous benefactor, we are able to offer scholarships. So if anybody is interested in attending Vacation Bible School, please don't forget to take the registration form, which are in the back of the table under Pope Francis and Bishop Wack's picture. Or you can email me and I will be happy to email you the registration package, but we have to have it back by tomorrow afternoon. Tomorrow is our deadline. If you have any other questions, please don't hesitate to contact me. My information is in the bulletin. Thank you and have a wonderful rest of your evening.
Thank you. And just a special message here also, we received a phone call in the office this past week letting us know that this person had received text messages from Father Lecary asking for money. Please be assured that these are bogus text messages if you get one, and we are trying to get this cleared up. This is not Father Lecary texting you asking you for money, okay? Just so you know that. St. John's School is hiring teacher assistants for the 2023-2024 academic year beginning in August. Candidates must be fully committed to the school's mission and pass a level 2 background check. Contact Mr. Duncan in the school office if interested. And lastly, perhaps you received the open of the doors here, a prayer for protection during hurricane season. We are in hurricane season now. We don't want to be affected by one of those storms here, so let us utilize our power of prayer and pray together the prayer for protection during hurricane season. It's also on the screen. God our Father, creator of the universe and Lord over all creation, we humbly stand before you as your children in thanksgiving for your loving care and protection. We ask that you keep us safe from all hurricanes which may threaten us in the coming seasons. Protect us from all fear and anxiety and storms. Give us a heart of trust and hope and love and mercy. You alone have the power to command the sea, the wind, and the rain. You alone bring peace, calm, and safety. Father, we thank you in advance. You are our only refuge. We ask this in the name of the Lord Christ Jesus. Amen. Stand. The Lord be with you.
And with you.
Almighty God bless you, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.